we are going to witness another premiere of a quartet, number one as well. And our wonderful composer and gentleman, Andrew Rudin, is here with us from Texas and New Jersey.
New Jersey, okay.
Texas, New Jersey. So, anyway, the tomato is a potato, you know. So, but anyway, originally from Texas.
Yes.
And, you know, I was in Odessa, Midland, Odessa, Texas, myself.
You have my sincerest sympathy.
Well, I was born in Odessa, Ukraine, you know, but I remember the same spelling and everything.
That's a different Odessa.
Nice orchestra, really nice.
Yeah, right.
Anyway, so without any further delays, please welcome Andrew Rudin, who's going to say a few words.
I wrote this piece about a little over a year ago, after a long dry spell in which nothing creatively seemed to work out for me. I've been writing music at that point for more than 60 years, and this was a rather depressing turn of development at that time. And then, for reasons that who can say why, all of a sudden I had this impulse to write the piece that you're about to hear. I have to say that it had its origin in a conversation that I had with Mark maybe 7 or 8 years ago, in which I heard them playing some of these same Beethoven Opus 18 quartets and was so thrilled by it. Mark had said, yeah, but we really need a little one movement thing to maybe open things. And I said sort of sarcastically, well, if I write it, will you play it? He said, of course. You know, so that was always in the back of my mind with these wonderful players, and and then all of a sudden I began to write that piece, and it came so welcomely and so happily that I was really, well, as you see, it's marked impetuoso. I felt very impetuous as I charged ahead putting this piece together, and I sent the movement to Mark, and thinking, well, maybe want to play that movement. But then it began to occur to me that there needed to be a second movement. There needed to be some kind of second thoughts after that. I look at it now and I think, it takes a long time to figure out what the subject of something really is when you do, because the piece comes to me. I don't come with a plan. I sort of find out where the piece takes me, and so until I get to the end, I don't know where I'm going, really. After the fact, it seems to me that you might say that movement one represents, we could almost put the title, now. You know, that's where I am now. But then I thought, well, I need the balance. It needs to be, where did that come from? And so the second movement, you might say, is my looking back on the period that was so difficult for me, where nothing was happening, and I look back on it with a certain sadness and a certain puzzlement about how I got through it. And of course, we all did that during that period. I can't close off my remarks without telling you that this has been a most wonderful experience. Usually you have a premiere, you come, they play it, it's over, and you're happy, or I hope. But this time, a premiere spread over 3 days, so I got to hear the same piece 3 different times with these wonderful, very generous performers who have welcomed my piece so beautifully, and I'm very, very grateful, and so I hope you'll find something to enjoy here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.